Using a flag on an email does all kinds of things within Outlook. The primary purpose, I believe, when they created it was just so that you would know when something was flagged and it bring your attention to this message. It highlights it in yellow, puts a little flag there. The other messages read like a normal message would inside of your email box. For example, like here, these are not flagged, but we can flag them and they show up a little bit different, right? So that's just kind of what flags do and look like. So that's a general understanding. But what do you do with a flag? Well, a flag automatically becomes a task. So if you look at your tasks, so it automatically creates a task in Task Manager, which we're going to talk about a little bit later here. Let me see if you can see it there. I know you can see it here. Here it is right here. All right. So that's something that tasks does for us, or excuse me, flags does for us. But when we complete that item, so let's look, and this is one of the downsides. Notice it's right there. All right. All right underneath 2019 tax returns. When I complete that task, right? So I'm going to mark it complete, check. Notice here that it now checks it off here. Now, when I delete this message, notice here, it deletes it completely from my tasks. So if you're like me and you keep notes inside of your tasks, this becomes very problematic. And so what else can you do with flagged messages? What we learned in another video, see the other video on creating Outlook rules, but you can also key off of flags. So flag is a big deal. So you can say, hey, if this message has a flag, I want you to automatically do something. So let's see here, for example, I'm going to send myself a message here. All right. And I'm going to say test flag. Now this is going to use a automated rule within Outlook. I'm going to send it. You're going to see it come into my inbox here for just a moment. And then it will move itself into my flagged folder. So here I'm updating. See, it's come in and then it disappeared. And then it moves over to my flagged folder. Now, why is this important? Because you're going to learn that you can do a lot of things with this flagged. And here it is right here. So you're going to learn that you can do a lot of things with the flagged symbol. It will allow you to do all types of automation. So you can also use keywords, right? Like OT2, for example, inside of the subject matter, and it'll automatically flag a message as well. So let's go take a look at that here, real quick. We're going to do one of those as well. So here you can see I'm sending an email message from my personal email, and I'm going to send it over to Technology Milestones, and I'm going to put in this key phrase right here, OT2. So I'm going to go ahead and hit send, and you're going to see that come in. Now notice here, the flagged is one. So we have one as a flagged. So here comes the message, and notice it just blinks on the screen quickly and automatically moves into this section here. Now notice here that because I sent it here, I'm sending a message from the actual account for my Technology Milestones email to my Technology Milestones email. But here I'm sending it from my personal account into my Technology Milestones account. And why am I doing that? Well, just to give you a hint, I take and move these files using a product that Microsoft has called Power Automate. Now we're going to go into more detail about Power Automate at a later time, but do you see here where it says copy flagged Outlook 365 emails to OneNote? I like to keep a copy of all my flagged important emails so that I can search them with my other notes that I may have for meetings and things like that. So let me show you what that looks like in OneNote. Now remember, we sent over two messages. One was test flag content, and the other one was OT2 task. And the reason why is because I want to keep all of this detail. And in Microsoft, when you start moving email into tasks and trying to automate the process, which we're going to talk about in another video, this information can get lost very easily. So I keep a backup copy of everything right here, as well as in Outlook, so that I can have balanced copies and be able to look and find information.